Childlike Erling, when you're that quality, you spot it from the first kick on the ball, in fact.
He had an attitude to score goals, and that's the most important thing in football.
The best player in the world right now is from this little town.
Bryne is a small town, only 12,000 lives here. People quite friendly, but quiet. You can see that in Erling. He doesn't speak long sentences, and that's normal here.
Hva tenker du om at søskenbarnet ditt nå slo deg som yngste A-lagsspilleren?
Det går fint.
Erling was born in England, in Leeds, in 2000. Alfie and his family came back to Bryne in 2004 or 5. Started to play in a team when he was 5 or 6 years old. He was a natural goal scorer. I could see that when he was very young.
Så vidt jeg ser, så du sønnen til...
Erling Haaland.
Det helt riktig. Du heter Erling, og du skårte 2 mål. Hvem det som har lært deg å skåre mål? For farten kunne det ikke.
Jeg aner ikke. Meg selv.
Han får ikke noe æren for det han.
Nei. Alt andre får han æren for.
I think you have to start with the parents, with the genetics. Because we talk about his father a lot, of course, Alfie Haaland. He was a very, very good player. But we don't talk enough about Erling Haaland's mother, who was at youth level at one point a national champion in heptathlon. So he was born into a real sporting family with just incredible pedigree on all sides.
Erling was gentle, nice, funny, but he was 1 out of 40. For us, it was all about to develop the human being first, and after that, the football thing.
In a small place like Bryne, the role of the football club is to keep people active, to be a social place for the kids. It's not necessarily like a meat grinder to get the most talented footballer out there. So the emphasis is on things like how to behave and be a good teammate.
I was a teacher to Erling, and he told me, school is not important, he's going to be a football player, a star. I told, no, no, school is important. No, no, he told me, that's not important for me, I'm going to be the best in the world.
He was very small, but when he was about 12, 13, he grew very fast.
We saw from Erling was 11, 12 that this is some special because he had the technical ability. So the only thing that was missing was a bit of the physics. And we knew in 4 or 5 years this will explode.
He had the speed. He didn't quite have the strength the way he bullies defenders right now, but he was always smart. He knew the right areas to go. He timed his runs. You can still see that even though he has added on top of his game with the physique.
In the dressing room, he was like he was 25. I remember him coming in there and like, almost like he was the captain of the team sometimes. And he was like, how are you doing? You were not used to that when 15 years old came in there. As you said, they were shy and, well, he was not like that.
A player like Erling, you don't create them. Erling is responsible for Erling. But Bryne and our team and the club, we were a good and safe arena for him to grow.
I think Bryne has a big impact on Erling. Of course, growing up here, being part of the football culture, we feel that he cares about this place and this is his home.
I Norge, på Bryne, 24 år her. Nå står Høyge, jeg snakker han, det var januar, han kommer, besøk. Og så han til meg gave. Det er veldig glad.
Every time Erling changes club, this town changes color. In Norway, most kids have a favorite team already. So if you're a Man United fan, you can't just change to Man City. But it seems like we all have agreed that it's okay to have two favorite teams in England now.
I'm very proud of how we represent our region and our town in a very good way. And that will make me proud, not if he is first or runner-up in the league.
I hope to see Erling back in the Bryne shirt, but I don't think it's in my time, maybe.
Even the idea that millions of people are potentially watching something like this and hearing about what kind of town Bryne is quite surreal, because it is a very small and in some ways unremarkable place.
When you're from Bryne and traveling around the world, everyone has something to talk to you about, because everyone wants to talk about Erling. That's a fun thing for us from this little town.